Last year we came here as an unsigned band. We sort of had done all the work that we could on our own, and we were looking for somebody to basically come in and partner up with us on everything we had done. We were out of resources and money, and we didn't know what was really going to happen. And we, you know, we came out of it with Dangerbird Records signing us, which was a very big deal for us. And in this last year now, we're back here with all this great stuff that's been happening as a result of the work that we had done and being in partnership with them. And it's been really exciting. I mean, South By is an onslaught of like cacophony, food, bad food, good food, great music everywhere you turn.
Beer.
The only reason we are experiencing any of this is that true word of mouth thing of music lovers just spreading the word and being really passionate about what we're doing as a band. So it's pretty exciting to have that.
Another beautiful thing is we've been meeting families. Like, the daughter put the dad onto the record, and now the dad's a fan, and he's telling the mom, and like the brother's now into it.
Which I don't remember ever being in the same record my parents were into.
They all walk into a talent agency.
You know, this band, there's no playback, it's not auto-tune, there's no DJ. It's just straight up about six musicians working it out on stage and leaving nothing behind every night. And I think that you don't always get that experience a lot of times now with the live music experience. Well, that was the cool thing about finally being signed and putting out the record, was that they were into the idea of putting out like 180 gram thick vinyl. And you work so hard on the artwork and all this stuff, and then most of the time it literally gets reduced to a postage stamp on iTunes, and you're like, that's what it, and so to see the artwork in its, you know, full format and to hold this object, it's an amazing experience to look at that.
I think musically we all just have like an amazing kind of diverse listening process. Like this guy right here,
I've got a crazy taste in music.
And me, I'm like a big rock chick. I'm totally into heavy kind of metal stuff. I love Tool, and you would never think that seeing me, this like girl that hops on stage and like sings like
shake a tambourine like no one's been
rocking it out. But like, that's what I listen. I listen to a lot of Radiohead, and you know, I got back into my System of a Down records recently.
Great band, awesome. Great album.
Yeah.
Well, the songs sound happy, but when you actually listen to what the songs are about, there's nothing happy. Actually, almost there's not a happy lyric maybe in almost the whole record. I wanted there to be that juxtaposition, a little bit of darkness and edge to what we're actually talking about on the record, you know. The inspiration for that stuff is just, you know, I've never been really that lucky in love, and just had some pretty bad experiences, and Money Grabbers, just that stone cold truth where you wake up one day and you realize that the person you're with and you think it's for love is there for slightly different ulterior motives, and what a kind of punch in the gut that moment can be. You know, it's funny, that song is about somebody and she knows who she is, and she was actually going to come see us in New York, and I don't think she had heard the song, and then she heard the song and she's like, I'm not coming to the show after all. And I was like, truth hurts, I suppose.
Yeah.
Thank you.